So I did a video some time ago about how I wanted Notion to get offline mode. Well, that day has come. Notion have announced today that they're introducing offline mode. This is a pretty big release. Many people have been waiting it for over 7 years. I certainly have. And it is something that I think a lot of people like. But it's not just the only feature that Notion have been releasing recently. So I want to recap some of the latest announcements that you might have missed, including offline mode. So today's video is kindly sponsored by SetApp. If you're on Mac or iOS, you'll absolutely love SetApp. You get 260 apps in one subscription. So check it out below if you're interested. I think you'll love it. Thanks to those guys for sponsoring today's video. So let's have a look at not Notion offline first, but Notion Calendar. Now, Notion Calendar has been doing pretty well. It's got some definite upgrades in terms of the new Notion Meet, but they just announced something called the List Panel. Now, this combines databases with a calendar. So essentially, you're able to drag Notion database items into your calendar. This is really beneficial because it almost becomes a little bit like what Trello's doing now with the inbox and your being able to plan. You essentially get a planner to some extent. So you can time block, you could schedule a task. You could basically just use this as a traditional to-do list slash daily planner, which can be incredibly helpful for a lot of people. So that is actually a very underrated release. They sort of casually just posted this. It wasn't really like a hard post, but this is a good release. So I definitely recommend checking that out as a new announcement. Next thing they did is they hit iOS with Notion Mail, and they also introduced it into over 18 languages, which is definitely a big upgrade. So iOS users now have Notion Mail on the go, and it's a pretty big release. They really fine-tuned it. I've got some screenshots as well if you want to see it in action. And they announced that as well, which is great news. For a lot of people, just being able to access that on mobile is a bit of a game changer. It's also got offline mode as well, and still the AI features come along with it too. Now, this wasn't just what they released over last week. They also put GPT-5 in, which for many people is definitely an upgrade to their software. Some people might be arguing it's not so much, but it definitely has helped a lot of people begin to use it inside of their systems. But Notion AI has always been something that I haven't really been orated collectively, just because I don't think that it had the killer feature that it needed. But they released, or they rebuilt Notion AI completely from the ground up. And essentially you can hook up a database to it with some of the information that you have and build a database based on the context of that, which I think is a killer feature for a lot of people. But it also changes my mind into thinking, is Notion gonna slowly become these like lovable replit alternative apps, but with more power behind it, if that makes sense? So could you use this Notion platform to essentially vibe code a app? Is what we did with Toolfinder to some extent. When we first released Toolfinder, we vibe coded to some extent without the AI in the system. And we used some AI to basically pre-build the pages and things like that. And it actually created an initial business for us. And then we obviously turned it into something that actually fully developed now. But it was definitely a good starting point. But now they could have, with the domains, the Notion AI, and other aspects of this, more of a fully fledged system if you wanted to release something that was more static. So it could be an interesting take in the future. But finally, they're doing much smaller things like checkboxes with more colors. Like, that's just a small thing, but definitely a huge change. And this is just a month before they announce their Make a Notion event. And I was looking through the schedule trying to find any clues. One other prediction is I think Notion's gonna come out with some proper merchandise for people to buy. It feels like they should have come out with that for now, but I almost have a good feeling that that could be on the cards. That leads me to the offline mode. Offline mode is now fully acceptable. They've been rolling this out partially for the last 2-3 weeks, apparently, and it's been getting good adoption levels. And it's taken a year since their last event to officially announce it. It took them 11 months to actually get this out from their last announcement. So it's good, obviously a long time in the making, but one that I'm sure all of you will love if you're Notion users. So that's the latest on Notion. Again, if you want to check out SetApp, it will be linked below. SetApp's a powerful way to get a bunch of new apps in one subscription, and you can find it linked there. So thanks very much for stopping by, and I will see you in a future video, I'm sure. and let's see what's planned for Notion. If you have any predictions of what's coming, do put it in the comments below. Thanks very much, and I'll see you soon.